The first thing I remember is a look. Maybe it's a bit stupid to say, but it was almost like an angel standing over me.
What's special about Bruno's story is that it happened to a healthy man with no previous history of heart disease. Ischemic heart disease has many faces, and the one this patient experienced was the most violent, the most aggressive, and the one that causes the most mortality. The patient was lucky enough to have his coach by his side.
My coach, who had just finished his day, was supposed to tidy up the gym, and for some reason he had an intuition. And although he never normally does it, he went down to the changing rooms to check whether everything was all right. And he found me there, lifeless, on the floor of the shower.
Emergency services were called right away, and they gave him electric shocks to restart his heart.
The patient was admitted to intensive care and immediately taken to the cath lab to manage an acute coronary syndrome following cardiac arrest due to ventricular fibrillation, following thrombosis of an anterior interventricular artery, which has been successfully unblocked during an interventional procedure. Time is very precious in this type of procedure because the longer the delay, the greater the damage to the heart muscle. In the case of our patient, the MRI scan was performed a few days later and showed that the damage was extremely limited thanks to this exceptional treatment, which enabled him to be resuscitated in a very short time with rapid destruction of the thrombosis. The first aim when following up our patients is to offer a CT scan to study possible structural abnormalities of the stent. Thanks to the continuous development of imaging technology and the introduction of photon counting technology, we now have an imaging modality that has a major impact on patient follow-up.
This is an issue close to our hearts, because at the Cardio-Thoracic Center, we are working with Siemens Healthineers to prepare for such developments, in particular the integration of the CT scanner and cross-modality imaging from the CT scanner to the cath lab.
You can get a thorough checkup and investigate any issues thanks to the new non-invasive technologies available today.
It was an interlude in my life. It was an event, not one I chose, but thankfully I was very lucky. It's a time that will remain in my mind and in my heart for life.